Hi, subdural abscess. The word abscess means the collection of the pus. So, subdural abscess means the collection of the pus between the dura and the arachnoid matter. These are the coverings of the brain, which are three in number, biomatter, arachnoid matter, and the dura matter. And the collection of the pus between these two layers is called the subdural abscess. Pathology. Infection separated by the erosion of the bone and the dura by the thrombophlebitis. And the pus separated to the subdural spaces. Come to lie against the convex surface of the cerebral hemisphere, causing the pressure symptoms. With the time, pus may get loculated at the various places in the subdural spaces. Now we see the clinical feature with which a patient of the subdural abscess present. First of all, meningeal irritation, that is headache, fever, malaise, increasing drowsiness, neck rigidity, and positive kerning sign. And the kerning sign is that when we extend the leg, when the thigh is flexed, these cause the abdominal pain and show the kerning sign is positive. Now, cortical venous thrombophlebitis, aphasia, hemiplegia, hemianopia, Jacksonian type of the epileptic fits are also seen in the subdural abscesses. Raised intracranial tension, papillary dermatosis, dilated pupil, involvement of the other cranial nerve. Now, the investigation, we can do CT scan, MRI, lumbar puncture, and the angiography. Exploratory burr hole is also important investigation. Now we see the treatment of the subdural abscess. First, we give the antibiotic to the patient. Then, a burr hole is a procedure for the drainage of the excessive fluid or pus. Now, craniotomy and the abscess drainage. Craniotomy also help in the abscess drainage. Once the subdural infection is treated, we will give attention to the causative agent which required cortical or the radial mastoidectomy for the permanent treatment. Thank you.